congratulations on the victory. Walk through that final round. It's pretty chaotic in there. Like, a little bit of trouble with that guillotine.
Not as much trouble as he did after being sat down twice, but yeah. No, it was close. It was right under my neck. It was squeezing a little bit, but I knew if I stayed in half guard that I'd be all right. But I thought that in the next round it was starting to get tighter and tighter, and I could hear the crowd react, and I just thought, well, there's no way I'm tapping in front of these lords. So it was like, you're even going to get out, you're going to go to sleep. And next round my head popped up. So, but yeah, it was close. It was close, but not close enough.
So for a good performance, even though you did get into some of those situations, like you mentioned, getting stuck in that choke.
Say again.
Overall pleased with the performance, even after it was done the most.
Yeah, I mean, a little bit slow to start. He was unorthodox. I knew that coming in. Took me a little bit longer to get a read on him. He changed his angles and his attack up a lot. But yeah, once I sort of found my right, the feeling getting tired. I know I got a good engine, and I could hear the corner saying, keep the pressure. And I could hear him getting tired, and I could see him slowing down. Especially on that third round, I knew I sort of guessed it was one each. I thought, just keep the pressure on. I said yesterday, if I keep the pressure on anyone, they'll start to show cracks, and minus the guillotine. That's what he did in the third.
And then you mentioned those fans. In fights in Las Vegas, you don't really see full venues this early on the fight card. Seems pretty cool out there from the first fight, so looking at the crowd.
Yeah, they knew the time was on early, didn't I? If you want him in there from the start, call me on early. But no, that's the UK crowd feel. That's wherever you go in the UK, wherever the card is, wherever it's strong, weak. They show up from the first fight, and that's why it's one of the best places in the world to fight. So even though I was on early, I knew the crowd would be packed, ready to go.
The broadcast kept calling you the Welsh GSP throughout the entire fight. Do you embrace that moniker, or do you just want nothing to do with it compared to GSP in past fighters like that?
No, it's very, very high praise. I mean, who else better to be compared to in my eyes? The best to ever do it. One of my idols in the sport. And if I can achieve a third of what GSP achieved, I'll be able to retire an happy man. So they can keep comparing me to the greatest as long as they like. I welcome it with open arms.
Finally, when do you want to get back in there? Any names you want? Like, at this point, can you start asking for specific names? Since you do keep winning the games.
Yeah, no, I'd love to get a rank fighter. Sun Tzu, Ricky Simone, any of those guys. I even said, look, I want to fight in June. I've got an holiday button in July. My missus will boot right off if I don't take her on holiday. So it's got to be June. Even if I've got to go up the featherweight and pick on one of the bigger boys, it's got to be June.
Well, Paul Craig seems to think there's a fight in Glasgow in June.
There we go, Ed. There we go. Scotland and Wales are getting on a Celtic card again.
Jack, you've been counting down to this moment for a long time in your career. Did it live up to the expectations? Because, you must have been watching these events for years thinking, I'm going to be there one day. What was it like to be in there?
Yeah, it's funny. I had a memory on my phone about 3 days ago, and it was 5 years to the day. Jack Marshman had tickets for UFC London. It was when Manuel fought Corey Anderson, and me and my mate couldn't make it, so me and my mate swiped the tickets on the slide. And we were front row watching, and I was like, 5 years later, I'm here fighting it myself. And even on the walkout, I had to switch myself back on, because I was like, this is insane. I've experienced big crowds in Cardiff and stuff, but then you times the capacity by like five. It was next level, so it's something that I'll take to the grave with me, that one, insane atmosphere.
Do you feel a sense of camaraderie? Does it feel like Team UK going into this? Because I felt like they're all kind of buzzing and vibing together this week. Is that the kind of feeling that was in the fighter hotel?
Yeah, I mean, it's really very much been that this week. All the guys have been very supportive and chatting, which is nice to see familiar faces, especially people like Paddy and Molly came up on the cage when I seen them, and I fought with Vegas and stuff with them. So it's good to see them. They bring a bit of atmosphere and a bit of fun to fight week. Making it all about cutting weight and counting down the days to fight. So I look forward to having a little part of them now afterwards as well.
Finally, just wanted to know, you and your dad embraced in the middle of the octagon afterwards. Obviously, he's probably counting down to this moment as well. I know he's been a coach in these situations many times, but was that a special moment for you guys?
Yeah, I think it's very special, especially for him. Like you say, he's done it with other guys, Brett and Jack. But it probably means, not that he takes their fights any less serious than mine, but the fact that his son probably means a little bit more to him. And it's a great moment for him, great moment for the gym. To get a win in the UFC for anyone in the gym is big, especially when it's your own son. You have to ask him about that one. I don't want to start him off, he'll start crying again, I swear.
Jack,
Go on, sir.
I love it. Yeah. How worried were you going into that third round, Jack? Because it seemed like a very, very tight fight.
I don't know if I was worried. I thought it was 1-1. The corner thought it was 2-0. I had a feeling that it was 1-1. But I could feel him getting tired. I could feel at the end of the second round, I could hear him breathing heavy, he was backing up way more. And his shots were becoming a lot more readable. And my boxing coach, Gary Lockett, always says to me, straight arrows. You know, when they get tired, they start winging well, keep them straight. And I think that's what led to that first knockdown. I mean, he came wild and I came down the pipe. And obviously the guillotine, I'm a little bit worried for a split second, but I was confident, especially with the second knockdown, that I didn't have. To be honest, at the very end of the fight, after the armbar, I ended up with an elbow and I felt him go a little bit, I don't know if it was just in my head or, but I felt him go a little bit limp. Maybe if I had a little bit longer, I could have done a bit more of that. But when the final bell went, I was confident I'd done enough.
Jack, you mentioned those knockdowns there, just over here, Jack. You mentioned those knockdowns in that chaotic third round. Is there a sense of you that you enjoyed the chaos in there, biting down on that mouthpiece and just throwing down? Were you surprised that you were able to endure that at that point of the fight?
Was I surprised I was able to? I may not be the most brash of personalities, this loud mouth. I don't talk a lot of trash. But I grew up in martial arts where it was just train and fight, train and compete, train and fight. So although I don't come across as that type, I know if it comes down to it, I can grind it out and bite down and fight with the best. And I've been doing it all my life, and it's second nature to me. You know, I don't look the type, I know, but if I that's what I got to do, that's what I got to do. And he didn't surprise me that he endured it. You know, coming from the area of the world he comes from a great gym with Mark Henry and Frankie Edgar and all those guys. I knew he was going to be tough. You only got to watch the last couple of fights, so I knew he wouldn't go away easy. I did think on that third knockdown he was going to be out there, I cracked him on his way up. But yeah, all credit to him, he was tough. I don't know how he fought, he won the third round at the end. I know I heard him complain a little bit, but no, credit to him, he was a tough guy.
Obviously, everybody would like to finish, but those sorts of fights that go the distance where you really test yourself against a tough opponent, is there a sense of achievement in that, in grinding out a wall like that and learning a lot about yourself in the process as well?
Yeah, look, I love a finish, but I couldn't have done no more. I pushed as hard as I could, and I had a little bit, I wouldn't say tired, but when it's just frantic like that, you're not really thinking, and you're just fighting on instinct. So I did try my best to get him out of there. Couldn't put him away. You know, I'd love to put him out there, but I just couldn't. I couldn't have physically pushed any harder to try and put him away. And you know, he was a tough little fucker, fair play to him.
Well done on a hard fought.
Thank you.
Jack, are you ready? Jack.
Sorry, Lewis.
Congratulations on the win, buddy. 16-0, really tough fight, close rounds. Can you tell us your assessment of what Valiant was like in there for you and where you promoted the rankings of the guys you faced in the past?
Yeah, toughest test to date by a long stretch. Just very unorthodox, very unpredictable. But I knew that coming in. I knew he's not the most like, you know, clean cut guy in the world. Everything he does, he's got the unorthodox attacks. He spins, he dips, he cuts the angle. He doesn't enter like most fighters do. So I knew it was one of those. It's going to be hard to find sparring partners for that type of guy. You just got to work him out on the feet. Thankfully, I got a good fight IQ and a good eye for things, and managed to work him out as the fight went on.
A sad day for our sports fans today. I don't know if you're aware, but Wales, the national rugby team, lost to Italy. A shock result. Do you think your win will sort of do anything to put a smile back on their faces after seeing that?
Yeah, hopefully. I mean, we haven't had the best run of luck with the rugby this year, so someone had to pull out the bag. Me and Brett are doing all we can to keep Welsh sports fans happy for a little bit.
Yeah. And did you manage to catch up with Corey? Obviously, she took a loss just moments before you. Did you manage to catch up to her backstage at all?
No, I warmed up in the same change room, but I was obviously, as Corey was coming out, I was ready to walk out, so I had a chance to see her. I know it was a close fight from what I managed to see the first two rounds. But I'm sure she'll come back from it. She's only young, you know, she's still a kid in this game, Corey. She's got plenty of time on her side, and she's in a good place, good gym, so I'm sure she'll bounce back. The sky is still a limit for him.
Brilliant. All right, Jack.
Jack, the... how's it going?
Good.
The guillotine did look very, very tight in that third round. As you came out of it, the crowd went nuts. Are you aware of them cheering at that moment when you get out of the guillotine? And if you are aware of that, how much extra motivation does that give you to carry? Because you finished that round so strong. It was the most dominant round of the fight.
Yeah, you know, you get in that type of spot in an empty arena and maybe it ends a different way, but I was stuck in it, and I could just hear the crowd getting louder and louder. And like I just said, I just sort of made an agreement with myself: is you're either popping out of this, or you're going to go to sleep. You're not. There's no way I'm tapping when they're all cheering like this. You know, I thought I'd gotten on my shield before I tap in front of these lot. And when I popped my head out, the crowd just went nuts, and that just spurred me on to finish the round as strong as I started it, and it made a world of difference.
Nice one, mate.
Jack, at the media day, you spoke about Joe Kazagi in terms of undefeated fighters. Just how important was it for you to see a Welsh fighter like that undefeated to know that maybe you could do it too?
Joe's reached the pinnacle of combat sport. He laid the sort of the track for everyone, didn't he? You know, he didn't go to one of the big gyms in America to train. Trained in a tin shed in Newbridge with his father, and was the most dominant sort of super middleweight champion and light heavyweight champion of all time. And just goes to show you don't need, you know, look at McGregor. McGregor did exactly the same thing. I know he's got all the money in the world now, but he started out with John Kavanagh, and he's still with him now. So just goes to show you don't need these big facilities and these big gyms to become a world-class fighter. And Carl Zaghi just proves that it can be done in the Welsh rallies as well.
Does it mean something to you to now have that will yourself kind of inspire the next generation?
Yeah, it does mean a lot. I mean, there's a lot of young kids in the gym now. I teach a kids class myself, and they all turn up in their tank t-shirts and the UFC gloves, and it means a lot to just give a little bit back. You know, there was plenty of guys like Jack Marshman, Chris Edwards, when I was coming up, and even Brett Johns, when I was coming up, they couldn't do enough for me. You know, would spar me as a youngster and help me out, take me to competitions with my father and give me tips. So to be able to give a little bit back now to the next wave, like I've gone from being the young kid with all the older boys in the gym, now being the older guy with all the young kids coming through. So it's just that sort of, you know, it'll just keep going our way. Now the kids coming up in 10 years time will be giving back to their kids. So it just means the world to, it's a tight-knit community in Wales. That's how we are. And we always give a little bit back. You know, my coaches have always done the same thing. So I'll continue to do the same for the kids as well.
Jack, you called out Ricky Simon and Asen Sal. Is there a specific reason why you called out those two names, or it just happens to be that they're in the 10 to 15?
Yeah, no, I just glanced around. I heard Bisping was going to give me a clip if I didn't call a name up, and he didn't ask me for a name then, didn't he? So I just glanced around yesterday when I was led in bed hydrating, and I clipped them two with the next sort of two in. And there's so many rankings out there, maybe a lot of the wrong ones, but I glanced they were the next two, and so why not?
Just finally, I know you're a big Khabib fan, but I didn't realise you're going to replicate being stuck in a guillotine like Dustin Poirier got him. So yeah, please don't play us with us like that again.
I'll try my best. That wasn't meant to be part of the script, trust me.
Well done.
I'll be quick because I'm sure you want to get the So about 6 months, 5 or 6 months time, you're coming up to 10 years in this game. You know, and you've been through all the biggest organisations, even through amateur, the biggest shows, and major way from Cage Warriors all the way up to UFC now. How important is it that you had that journey before you got to where you are today now?
Yeah, of course, it's like an apprenticeship. No, I've never done a day's labour in my life, but I don't suppose you could go and plaster a wall if you've never picked up a trowel before. So you've got to serve your apprenticeship, you know, whether it's in local comps, the open mats, stuff like that. I always tell the guys in the gym, get our amateur experience. You know, learn. Don't be one of these guys that got to learn on the job. You know, you don't want to be in the UFC experiencing things that you've never experienced before in front of 20,000 fans when all the cameras are on, there's millions watching. Learn it as you go. You know, get yourself a good amateur record. Go to the IMAF. Find yourself a good pro show. Work your way through the ranks. Cage Warriors are doing it perfectly nowadays. So yeah, serve your apprenticeship before. You know, there's too many people in this game want to get too far ahead of themselves and they get the UFC, lose their two fights, and they're back to the bottom of the pile. You know, if you do it the right way, there's no reason why you can't come here to stay.
And with MMA being one of the fastest growing sports in the UK at the moment, how important do you feel that as a role model, even though you're still young yourself, some of these youngsters coming through, right? Especially with the guys on the streets nowadays?
Yeah, look, it's crazy to be honest, because like I just said, I was one of those kids in the gym looking up to Jack and Brett and Chris and John Phillips and all these guys thinking, God, one day I'll be on Batman, one day I'll be on Cage Warriors. So then now I'm sort of at the pinnacle myself and laying a path for the youngsters and the amateurs behind me. So it's very important. No, especially in Wales, there's not a lot for kids to do other than you're even in an MMA gym, you're either playing rugby or football, or you're out getting yourself into trouble. And there's a lot of kids in the gym with us even now that I know if we didn't have them in the gym, they'd probably be going down a different path in life. You know, Let's just be real, plenty of kids getting the drugs and drink from a much younger age than they should have. I was fortunate that this sport led me down this path. So I try my best to have an influence on the youngsters coming through and explain them that you don't need to be getting into trouble, you know. Trust the sport, you know, live the martial arts lifestyle, and it'll just make your life better.
Yeah, well said, and congratulations on your win, mate.
Thank you.
Yeah, just a quick one from me. We've got the bantamweight title match coming up, a rematch between Piotr Jan and Aljamain Sterling. How do you think that goes down?
I think Jan gets it done, but I think it'll be a much closer fight. I think Aljo will make adjustments. I don't think he'll come up like a bull in the china shop and try and get him down and sub him straight away. You know, I think he knows that Jan gets tougher as the fight goes on. So I think he'll be a little bit more calculated, but I just think Jan will have the answer eventually.
Congrats.
Thank you.